Welcome back to another episode of The Basics of Trading featuring Prateek and me. In the previous episode, we discussed support and resistance. What is polarity? Chart patterns like double bottom and double top. Today, we're going to level up and learn about indicators. Indicators are quantified and they solve the problem of ambiguity.
Hey Tame, what's up? Wanna begin learning about indicators?
Yes, let's do it.
Okay, so the first thing we learned was price action. Ki dekho price move ho raha hai, candlesticks mein kiye hum log. Then we went to chart patterns. Jo after we started learning, there's head and shoulders, which we didn't discuss, but we discussed support and resistance. Thoda discretion hai wahan pe. Right? Someone could draw that line differently.
Thoda vague ho sakta hai.
Correct. Tanmay would draw the line differently. I would draw the line differently. So that's a problem there, right? So how do we get exactness when you're actually analyzing demand and supply? Another way to do it is using indicators. Indicators basically are calculations on price and is calculated by a charting platform.
Got it.
Aapko line mein nahi draw karna hota.
Got it.
It comes calculated. So there is a consistency and it's quantified, right? So does everyone sees that indicator exactly as it should be?
Got it.
So jo sabse popular indicator hai, it's called the moving average.
Okay, what does that mean?
It's an average. So let's take a simple analogy to understand this better. Let's suppose you are analyzing a class. Okay. Class K marks. Now let's suppose the average marks the entire class got was say 60 marks. And then there is Chintu, okay, who got slightly higher than everyone else.
Got it.
And Chintu is say at say 75 marks. Now, is he higher than the average?
Yes.
Of course, yes. Let's take another example. Why don't you give me another name?
Prateek.
Okay, so.
Below average.
Prateek is sort of below average with 50 marks.
Got it.
Now the question is, in the next exam, is Chintu likely to score better than Prateek?
Likely, based on his previous performance.
Correct. Because last time, Prateek was below average and Chintu was above average.
Got it. Oh,
that's it.
So moving average would be the average of the averages.
So moving average actually in stocks is very simple. It's just the closing price of all the prices over a period of time.
Got it.
Right? And why is it moving? Because every day the market opens.
Closes at a different price.
So you
price.
Keep plotting that average every day and you draw a line through it.
Got it.
It basically looks like this, right? So this is called moving average. People generally call it like MA for short, right? So in charting platform, it'll show MA, MA. That's what moving average is. Where's the black marker? Okay. So this will be price, what I'm going to draw. So price will do this. It'll go up. It'll go down. It'll go down again. It'll go up. You'll have this movement that price is doing over a period of time. Now, iska average kya hai? Is what the moving average is. So the moving average would look something like this. This is, it sort of smoothens out pricing over a long period of time.
Got it.
Right? Now, how many days of average is it? Is what is the, it's called period. So, how many days of average are you taking? Every 50 days, I can point a point and plot it. Make sense?
Yeah, makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah. So, if I do say moving average 50, what does that mean?
50 days.
Yeah.
Pay price ka average kya hai?
Correct. So the most popular one on a daily chart is the 200-day moving average.
Okay.
Because it signifies like a longer term. So now you tell me, Let's suppose this is 200-day moving average. Okay, I'll rub this. Let's suppose you're 200-day moving average. Logically, if price is below the 200-day moving average, what do you think that means?
It's going to pick up because the average is 200. So it's more likely to gravitate towards 200.
Correct. So basically,
and historically for the last 200 days, it's, the average price has been this.
Yeah.
So it's not going to deviate too far from it. It's likely to.
Yeah. The
moving average is it's almost like a gravitational force of the stock.
It is actually. Yeah, you're totally right. So if it goes below, it tends to come back. If it goes outside, it tends to come back. And you used a good word, deviate. So how far is my price deviating from the average? It's a nice to know thing, you know. If your stock has gone to up, you're like, dude, this has gone really far from the historical average. Toh shayad abhi saas lega. Ye thoda Usain Bolt maar diya isne. Thoda it needs to breathe. And if it does this, then it'll come back.
Got it. Right. And 200-day moving average is interesting because if it goes higher than 200, what it means is this is more likely to be an anomaly because over the last 200 days it was here. No.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then how suddenly it's going so high? And the way for the 200-day moving average to gradually go up is for it to consistently go up over a long period of time. Only then will the average shift.
Exactly. So if ek do din ka spike aaya, moving average ko pata hi nahi chalega. Kehta I don't care.
Par 4 mahina lagatar 200 ke upar aa raha hai, to fir moving average automatically badhne shuru karega.
Perfect.
Ekdam batsman ke average ki tarah hi hai.
Correct.
Right?
Extend that a little bit. What do you
like? Agar batsman 5 saal ka tum average pakdo batsman ka.
Nice.
To batsman ko 5 aur saal सपोज 5 साल का मूविंग एवरेज 40 है
ठीक है हाँ ठीक है
तो बैट्समैन को अगर 40 से 50 मूव करना है तो अगले 3 साल उसको 60 का एवरेज करना पड़ेगा
कंसिस्टेंटली
करना पड़ेगा 60 का ताकि वो एवरेज उसका 40 से 50 हो जाए वैसा समझ गया इट्स एग्जैक्टली लाइक दैट
राइट तो बेसिकली आपके पास नॉइज है शॉर्ट टर्म में ऊपर जा रहा है नीचे जा रहा है मूविंग एवरेज उसको स्मूदन आउट कर रहा है सो दिस इज द एडवांटेज यू गेट फ्रॉम दिस अगेन इट्स नॉट प्रिडिक्टिंग कहां जा रहा है बट लाइक यू सेड
Correct.
Deviate कितना हो रहा है?
Gives an indicator. It makes the volatility feel less.
Yes.
Basically, moving average देख के आपको volatility से थोड़ा कम डर लगेगा क्योंकि हाँ ये तो अभी ऊपर नीचे हो रहा है पर 200 दिन देखेगा तो actually उतना load नहीं है.
Load नहीं है. तुमने क्या बोला last time? All
is well.
अच्छा तन्मय for moving average do something for me. Let's assume moving average is also acting like support. Let's assume that. ठीक है दिस इज एवेन्यू सुपरमार्केट्स डीमार्ट करके कंपनी है लेट मी जूम आउट अ लिटिल बिट यू कैन सी प्राइस जा रहा है ऊपर नीचे हो रहा है ऊपर नीचे हो रहा है एंड देन बीच में ये एवरेज है जो ब्लू लाइन है इट्स अ 200 डे मूविंग एवरेज हाउ डू यू नो लिखा एम ए 200
गॉट इट
जैसे मैंने यहां लिखा एम ए 200 तो नाउ एज यू कैन सी प्राइस वेंट अप केम डाउन डू यू नोटिस समथिंग हियर कैन यू जस्ट एक्सप्लेन दिस स्टोरी टू मी ऑफ प्राइस एंड मूविंग एवरेज
So what happened was that this where it rallied, right? Because this rallied, the moving average started going up
very slightly.
Very slightly, yeah. It started going up slightly.
Okay.
And then it came down again. Hang on.
These came back to its normal average.
Came back to its normal average.
And then it
then it started picking up again. And then it came here, and then it broke support and went lower. So you see the moving average all of a sudden plateaued. Like the trajectory it was going like this, it became
perfect.
Straighter.
Because yahan pe itne din tak sideways tha.
So if the deviation is too far, would it be fair to say that the stock is currently slightly overvalued?
Yes, it is. It also means the stock is in momentum.
You can change the moving average to a 50-day or 60-day.
Correct. So that's one thing you can do. You can shorten the moving average. So we can actually do that. Let me add a moving average, which is say moving average, add it. And I'll change this to 50. So we can see that there's a shorter moving average over here in cyan. Price went up. Again, it touched. Notice that. Touch okay, wapis se it went up. Okay, interesting, right?
Yeah, whenever the candlesticks break down of the moving average support, you see the trajectory of the moving average line just completely changes. It flattens out.
Yeah.
Right? Because
it's trying to adjust to the new price.
Agar batsman suddenly एक साल के लिए 40 के जगह 30 का एवरेज करेगा तो उसका ओवरऑल एवरेज सडनली 40 के जगह 35 बीच में आ जाएगा. सो दैट्स व्हाट हैपेंस टू दिस लाइन एज वेल.
करेक्ट, व्हिच इज गुड, राइट? इफ यू आर सीइंग दिस फ्रॉम अ लॉन्गर टर्म लेंस, यू डोंट वांट द मूविंग एवरेज टू शिफ्ट वेरी क्विकली.
करेक्ट, बट यू वांट टू बी अ ग्रेजुअल कर्व और अ ग्रेजुअल.
कंसिस्टेंसी इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द स्टॉक. यू कंसिस्टेंटली परफॉर्म करो, देन आई विल बिलीव यू आर अ गुड स्टॉक.
गॉट इट.
Now, let's see another thing. The first thing is you can shorten the moving average curve. हमने 50 करके देखा.
Correct.
There is something else called an EMA. What the EMA will do, it's just exactly like the MA, moving average. It's an exponential moving average. What it does is, it gives more weightage to the recent price action.
Correct. So, recent momentum is a factor.
Correct.
In determining the EMA.
So, that's what it is. Right? EMA and it is X... exponential moving average. ठीक है. अब what that will do is it will give more weightage to the recent price movement. So if generally we've been moving up and suddenly there's a dip, it will give a little more weightage to the latest dip because hey, what's happening now is more important than what happened equivated over 200 days.
Got it.
So that's another thing you can do. So what I'll do is I'll add another EMA to show you what it looks like.
So for a trader,
yeah.
An EMA is more valuable than MA.
I would say so, yes.
Yeah, because it gives you an opportunity to understand if there's money to be made now.
Yes.
In its current price movement.
So, same thing, 200-day moving average. They're both 200 days. Jo upar wala hai na, that's exponential. So, it's moving a little faster, but also telling you 200 days ka trend. So, it's given the last few days a little more weightage.
If you see the stock has rallied, it's found higher lows in the last, you know, in the last 6 months. How much is it? 8 months.
Correct.
Yeah.
But what we can do is we can also change the color of the EMA. So, we can see it better to say green. So I can see that green better with the exponential. Let me see if there's something else. If you notice over here. Okay. So if you notice over here, the blue line is taking its time and it's still plateaued. But the green line has dipped faster because that dip has come a little closer.
That dip has come a little closer. Also, it's seeing like a these last few months were slightly bearish for this stock.
Yeah.
So that's why short-term bearish movement mein long-term moving average pe utna farak nahi pada hai.
Correct.
Got it.
Another thing is, notice this rally here. That the markets have gone up, right? The blue line is not...
It's not completely dramatically changing. Yeah,
but the green line has. So that is one
advantage. Hockey stick vibe there, green line.
Ye dekho pehle aa
gaya. Ab nahi, abhi hockey stick nikal gaya.
So that's basically an indicator. So now everyone knows moving average कहाँ पर है. इसमें कोई discretion नहीं है. It's calculated and everyone sees the same thing. So that's an advantage. So when you're making a system, using an indicator is far more useful.
Correct.
Than a pattern.
It gives you a little bit more story about what's really going down.
And it's precise, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, perfect.
It's like opening the this thing of a car, bonnet of a car.
And seeing what?
Seeing क्या हो रहा है अंदर.
हाँ, correct.
Properly.
Yeah. That's exactly what it is. Okay, so one thing, pointing out the obvious here, right? But let me remove the 200-day normal average and just keep the exponential. And I'll zoom out. Now the stocks, if you didn't get the higher swing low thing, then if a stock is consistently above this exponential 200-day, we assume it's in an uptrend.
Uptrend, correct.
So ye to clearly uptrend hi hai. And if the winds change, sort of the EMA will give you a clue. Let me change this to say something like, say, X-side. X-side mein you can see
it's
that...
It's below the moving average. So correct. It's the downtrend, clearly.
So this is clear. Now, tell me this. Market bahut X-side ka gir raha hai. This goes a little bit up and this is like, I say, a 10%, 20% rally.
Resistance. It starts acting like... In a bearish market, it'll start acting as resistance.
Exactly. So now, if someone asks you, Tanmay, एक्साइट बहुत गिर गया, 20% ऊपर है, क्या ये अपट्रेंड में है? यू विल बी लाइक, डूड इट्स स्टिल,
इसका मूविंग एवरेज रेजिस्टेंस को पार नहीं किया,
हां तो अभी भी बहुत, अभी भी डाउन ट्रेंड ही है. वो 20% सुनने में अच्छा लग रहा है, लेकिन द ओवरऑल ट्रेंड इज स्टिल डाउन. So this is very, very useful for anyone, right? To know where is the market going. I know it's bearish right now. Simple.
Got it.
So Tanmay, I have a question. What if I tell you there is a stock, बहुत momentum है stock में, and it's moved up really quickly over a few days, बहुत ऊपर चला गया. What do you think is going to happen next?
It'll come down because too many people have bought too much of it. So it'll have to cool down a little bit.
Yes. So this is called overbought. When a stock has been bought too much and you're measuring it, ki agar momentum zyada hai, it'll sort of cool down a little bit.
Correct.
Okay. So the indicator which actually does this is the RSI.
What does that stand for?
So the RSI is the relative strength index.
Okay.
Okay. It basically measures the strength of the stock relative to itself. क्या पहले स्ट्रॉन्ग थे, अभी भी स्ट्रॉन्ग हो कि नहीं, सॉर्ट ऑफ.
दिस इज एन इंडिकेटर ऑफ द इन्फरेंस वी केम टू आफ्टर सीइंग द फर्स्ट इंडिकेटर.
यस एक्चुअली. ओके, इट्स आल्सो कॉल्ड द आरएसआई एंड वी ऑलवेज पुट अ पीरियड, राइट, ऑफ कितने दिन का ये मेजरमेंट है. 200 डे मूविंग एवरेज था, इट्स कॉल्ड द पीरियड. 14 आरएसआई इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर.
14 days.
14 candles actually, but yeah, 14 days. So now let's understand what the RSI actually does. I won't get into the calculation bit, but I'll explain what it's calculating. Okay, so let's say we have candle 1, candle 2, candle 3, candle 4, candle 5. Okay, and I'll put, I think that's it. Now, let's make this green, this green. This is also green, this is also green, and we have one red candle, which is this. Ab RSI kya karega? It'll find all the days it was up, so momentum, gain, 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 and then make a ratio of that gain with the down candle.
Okay.
And say zyadatar ye up tha, ki zyadatar down tha. And you will get a ratio which says ki ha, ye momentum up tha. It'll measure the open close, open close, open close, open close. Measure it versus the last day, open close, and make a ratio out of it. So far, the indicator that we discussed, moving average, it is on the price. Ye on the price nahi hota RSI, it is under the price, and it's an oscillator. Okay. So it oscillates, that means moves between 100,
0,
and 0. इसमें दो सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर्स हैं, एक है 80 और दूसरा है 20. ओके, जस्ट ड्रॉ दिस लाइक डॉटेड लाइन फॉर 20 एंड दिस डॉटेड लाइन फॉर 80. अब नाउ इन दिस केस द आरएसआई विल लुक समथिंग लाइक दिस. द मोमेंट द आरएसआई गोज अबव 80, वी से दैट इट्स ओवरबॉट एंड इट्स लाइकली टू कूल डाउन, राइट. And if the market comes down too much and it hits 8, it hits 20, we say, okay, it's oversold and it's likely to come up.
Oh, this is like a proper indicator of what the real value of the stock is and whether you should buy or no.
Yeah, it's very short term though, like because it's measuring momentum. I'm saying thoda sa niche aayega.
But for a trader, that's really important, right?
It is. So maybe you might book your profits if you're long on a stock at 80 in the RSI. It could be an exit indicator for you.
Correct.
कि short term में down नहीं आना चाहिए. मैं तो intraday trader हूँ. या दो तीन दिन में exit करना चाहता हूँ. तो 80 पे आएगा, I'll exit. So that's how you could use this tool to eventually make a system out of.
Got it.
Right. One problem though with the RSI, I'll say it right now, is that if the stock keeps going up, the indicator just यहाँ पे चिपक जाता है and just stays there. So that's a problem. But I mean, every tool has its downsides. But this basically measures momentum and then says, ha, momentum thoda sa bhi thak gaya, thoda sa it will take a break. Okay, Tanmay. So we have an example here. Ye excite ko hi continue karte hain. So ab just notice two things. We have price going up and down and niche.
Ha, we also have moving average here.
Hata do kya?
Nahi, mera nahi dena.
Theek hai na?
Sahi hai, haan.
Theek hai. तो अब नीचे दिख रहा है ना आरएसआई ये, और आरएसआई के ऊपर वो डॉटेड लाइन भी बने, तो वो डॉटेड लाइन के ऊपर गया तो हो गया
80 प्लस हो गया वो,
विच मींस दैट मार्केट
इट्स ओवरबॉट.
तो अब इसको जस्ट ड्रॉ लाइन फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर, लुक एट दैट. Can you see that?
So this part, right? Like you see here, it's like way above 80.
Yes. Keep drawing. There it is. Perfect.
Yeah.
So you'll notice, and you guys who are watching this, right? You can do this on any chart. Hmm. Ye 80 ke upar gaya. It took some time, but then it eventually started to fall, right? Wo overbought hua and then it fell down. Hmm.
So the second on the RSI, it goes below 20. It's likely to find some support and like we're likely to see a hammer there, like the demand.
Nice. Nah? You're bringing things together now.
Yeah. So if it goes under 20, it's like, oh, it's oversold.
Yeah.
You're likely, as you see the hammer stick go lower, you're likely to start seeing some demand there.
Nice.
Then it can start, you know, you'll start seeing a lot of bullish engulfing patterns right after that.
Oh, dude, this is just...
And then you'll start seeing higher lows after that.
I can't handle this.
And then the stock will rally and you can...
So
then,
proud.
When it reaches the top at resistance, you sell it. And then you're like, see you, thank you for the profit. From hammer to resistance.
Double top bhi ho sakta. Let's say, one question. Abhi yahan pe dip aaya, market upar chala gaya. Yahan pe phir dip aaya. Based on the RSI, will it go up?
End mein abhi, abhi jo hai na.
Haan, ye abhi market niche phir se dip kiya hai, but RSI kahan par hai?
एकदम बीच में है, एकदम 50 पे है.
तो क्या लगता है?
तो maybe it will just go actually
20 से तो बहुत दूर है ना.
अभी इसने अपना रेजिस्टेंस ब्रेक किया है और नया नया रेजिस्टेंस ढूंढने गया और नया सपोर्ट होगा. सो maybe
सो जस्ट बेस्ड ऑन द RSI टेल मी इज इट नियर 20 और नॉट.
या इट्स फार, इट फील्स लाइक इट्स फेयरली फार फ्रॉम 20.
या
सो इट्स नॉट गोना बाउंस इमीडिएटली.
परफेक्ट. So another example we have, and this is Britannia. Daily chart, let's see, abhi ye sideways chal raha hai, and the RSI is like roughly 40, pretty far from 20.
If not that far, it's further from 80 than it is from 20.
Okay, fine. Relative, nice.
Relative, yeah.
Market's falling, ye kafi bada fall aaya.
Oh, it's gone below 20.
What does that mean?
It means it's oversold.
Which means?
It's gonna rally back up.
I mean, it may rally, but yes.
Yeah.
Let's scroll up and see what happens. And that's exactly what happened.
This is also March 2020, so pandemic.
Pandemic. So tell me the pricing. It went from 2100 to?
To 3600, wow.
It's like 70-80% at least, right?
Yeah.
So that's interesting, right? So RSI over a daily chart, especially in this, really works well. So this is how oversold works for RSI.
Got it.
It is important to know that whatever we've discussed right now does not mean you should buy and sell based on this analysis. You're only getting a tool to understand where the market is. So don't actually make a decision based on this analysis yet.
Don't make any decisions until you have system.
Yes. We should do something apart from just analysis, right?
We should.
We should build like a system, right?
On the next episode.
Not yet. Let's learn a little more, but yes. The episode on the system is coming up next. Soon. Coming up soon. Batao. Cool. So what we're going to do next is do a summary of what we did so far.
Okay.
So I'll ask you a bunch of questions and this is quiz time.
Yes.
So, if price is above moving average 200, what kind of trend does it mean?
Price is above moving average 200. Oh, it's an upward trend.
Correct. And what's the downward trend?
If it's moving below
the moving average. Yeah, perfect. Yeah. And okay, fine. Cool. What's the difference between a moving average and an exponential moving average?
Moving average is of a particular time frame, like 200 days, etc., etc. An exponential moving average keeps the longer time frame in mind, but also gives weightage to the short-term moving average.
Correct.
So if a stock has been steadily moving upwards, but all of a sudden it takes a bullish turn, then the exponential moving average will reflect more of the bullish turn than the regular moving average.
Correct. It'll move a little faster than the slower moving average. Which is the norm. Perfect. Correct. Excellent. What's my next question? Okay, let's talk about the RSI. What's the full form of RSI?
Relative strength. It's not written there also.
It is actually.
Relative strength index.
Achha, cool. And what does it measure?
It measures the stock's current relative strength compared to itself.
Okay.
All right, that's what it means. What this means is, it's an indicator that tells you whether a stock is overbought or oversold. That's basically it.
All right. And if it's above 80, it basically means?
It's overbought.
And likely to?
Cool off and come down.
Come down a little bit. And the opposite is also true.
Also,
right?
Yeah.
Excellent. Cool. So I think that sounds good.
Yeah.
We learned about price action, technical analysis, ka kafi basics ho gaya.
Yeah.
But if we don't know how to place orders, hum to kuch kar hi nahi payenge.
Correct. So ye table hatao, laptop leke aao, khulte.
Theek hai. Are laptop do na koi. Internet connect and we'll place a few orders.
Let's start. Let's get into it.
Done. Lekin next episode.
You can check out the full course on learnapp.com about RSI. Here you will get a back-tested system using the RSI indicator. Check out the link in the description and get 2 months of access for absolutely free. And while you trade, you can analyze your stock fundamentals and history in depth, all thanks to Tickertape. And before you begin trading, one must have a Demat account, so open your own Demat account. All of these links are available in the pinned comments, so check it out. In the next episode, you will learn
moving average. And just click it.
EMA and RSI.
Kitna period likhna hai?
MA 200 dal de.
Very nice. So what I see over here is the dashboard. I can see the total amount of money in equity. You make a profit if market falls.
Correct.
Right? And this is, as you rightly said, called
shorting.
Shorting. Okay.
You're teaching RSI with Tanmay. Oh my god. I need a photo. I need a photo, man.
Camera roll, like, huh?
Yeah. It's not funny.
Kitna baar samjhana padega, huh?
नहीं बार बार इंपॉर्टेंट है लोग बोलेंगे मूविंग एवरेज पर खरीद लो वो गलत है
10 बार बोल दिया ना अभी अभी रुक और देखो एपिसोड
मत खरीदना अभी कुछ डोंट मेक अ डिसीजन